What happened during Ship 26 static fire test? Boeing Starliner launch finally scheduled. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Welcome back, everyone. Today is an exciting day as we will be covering the latest updates from Starbase about the Starship's flight preparation and other developments. It's been a while since we dedicated an episode to Starship updates, so let's dive right in. Starting with the preparations for Flight 4, I know many of you are eager for this information. Today, I visited the Cameron County website to check for any scheduled road closures. It appears that tomorrow's road closure has been revoked, but there are possible closure dates for June 6th and 7th. I'm fairly certain that the launch will occur on June 6th, with the 7th serving as a backup date in case of any unforeseen circumstances. A notice to mariners, not MAR, has been issued for possible closures on June 6th or 7th, 2024, from 7 a.m. to 11 a.m. Now let's see if there have been any updates from SpaceX or Elon Musk regarding the launch. SpaceX mentioned a June 6th launch 3 days ago, pending regulatory approval. There haven't been any other updates. On June 1st, Elon Musk shared that Starship Flight 4, which includes many improvements, is aiming to launch on Thursday. The main goal of this mission is to penetrate deeper into the atmosphere during reentry, ideally through maximum heating. Yesterday, he shared that the Starship is ready to fly. Let's now check the progress of the FAA Starship license. According to Christian Davenport, the FAA is ready to issue the IFT-4 launch license to SpaceX very soon, unless SpaceX makes any last-minute changes to the flight plan. That's all for the IFT-4 updates. I'm incredibly excited for this launch, and I'll tell you why. There are three reasons. The first is to witness the jettisoning of the hot stage ring, which has never been done before. The second is the Starship reentry part. Do you remember Ship 28 going through hot plasma during the last flight, IFT-3? That was quite a sight, right? Unfortunately, it didn't make it to the landing part, nor the reentry part. If it had, it would have been a significant achievement for SpaceX, as Elon Musk has repeatedly stated that the Starship's heat shield and re-entry are the most critical parts. The third reason is, of course, the booster's soft splashdown. Last time, Booster 10 missed this by a mile due to the filter blockage of liquid oxygen to the engines. However, for this launch, I hope they have figured out a solution for this blockage. That's all about my interesting parts. Now, I'd love to hear from you. What part of IFT-4 amazes you? Which part is important to you? Please share your thoughts in the comment box. I'll be replying to each and every one of you. Moving on to today's Ship 26 static fire test. Today, around 4:42 p.m., Starship 26 performed the first ever ship static fire on the new water-cooled flame trench at Massey's test site. Was it successful? The latest reports from there indicate that it was successful, but SpaceX has yet to comment on this. I don't think they will share about this as it's a prototype that still has a lot of work to be done. If you haven't heard about the new water-cooled flame trench system, don't worry, I made a video about it around 3 weeks ago, and I recommend you check it out. Before concluding today's SpaceX update, I noticed something odd. Ship 29 is currently stacked atop Booster 11, but it doesn't have a text decal or the SpaceX logo. Also, it's missing around 3 TPS tiles. With only a day left, do you think they will add these? I'm not concerned about the text decal as it's not of great importance, but what about the TPS tiles? I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. So, there you have it. IFT-4 is almost confirmed for a June 6th launch, and Ship 26 has completed its first static fire on the new water-cooled flame trench system. Now let's move on to other updates. The next update is something very, very interesting. But before that, please make sure you like this video and are subscribed to our channel. It's almost launch season and we have a ton of episodes coming up. I don't want you to miss out. Also, lately, many new viewers have been tuning in for our daily episodes, and I can see that in my analytics. I'm really happy about this, and I welcome every new member to our club. Your engagement and interest are what drives me and the algorithm. NASA and Boeing are gearing up for the launch of the CST-100 Starliner spacecraft on June 5th after a computer issue forced United Launch Alliance, ULA, to scrub the previous launch attempt. The Crew Flight Test, CFT mission, which will carry NASA astronauts Butch Wilmore and Suni Williams to the International Space Station, ISS, is now scheduled to launch on June 5th at 10:52 a.m. Eastern, with a backup opportunity on June 6th at 10:29 a.m. Eastern. The previous launch attempt on June 1st was aborted just 3 minutes and 50 seconds before liftoff due to a problem with one of the three redundant ground control computers. According to ULA CEO Tory Bruno, the issue was likely caused by a hardware or networking problem. Further investigation revealed that a power supply unit used by a portion of the cards in the malfunctioning computer was to blame. The unit, which controls valves used for replenishing propellants on the Centaur upper stage, was replaced with a spare, and functional checkouts have confirmed that all hardware is performing normally. Weather conditions are expected to be favorable for the launch, with a 90% chance of acceptable launch conditions on June 5th. NASA has reported no other issues with the Atlas V rocket, its ground support equipment, or the Starliner spacecraft itself. If the launch does not proceed as scheduled, NASA and ULA will stand down to replace expiring batteries on the rocket, a process that is expected to take around 10 days. The CFT mission is a critical test flight for the Starliner spacecraft, which is expected to carry astronauts to the ISS on operational missions starting as early as 2025. The spacecraft will spend around a week at the ISS before returning to land in the southwestern United States. NASA is eager to certify the Starliner for operational missions, and a successful CFT mission will pave the way for the spacecraft to become a vital part of the agency's crew rotation missions. The Starliner spacecraft is a reusable crew capsule designed to carry up to 7 astronauts to low Earth orbit destinations. It is launched on a ULA Atlas V rocket and features a heat shield to protect it during reentry. The spacecraft is equipped with a suite of advanced life support systems, including air, water, and waste recycling, as well as a navigation system that uses a combination of GPS and inertial measurement units. NASA's Commercial Crew Program, which includes the Starliner spacecraft, is a public-private partnership that aims to develop safe and reliable crew vehicles for low Earth orbit missions. The program is designed to provide NASA with access to a range of crew vehicles, reducing reliance on any single spacecraft or launch provider. The Starliner spacecraft is one of 2 crew vehicles being developed under the program, the other being SpaceX's Crew Dragon spacecraft. The CFT mission is a significant milestone in the development of the Starliner spacecraft, and NASA is eager to see the spacecraft perform in a real-world environment. The mission will test the spacecraft systems, including its life support systems, navigation, and communication systems. It will also test the spacecraft's ability to dock with the ISS and return to Earth safely. NASA and Boeing are working closely together to ensure the success of the CFT mission. Boeing is responsible for the design, development, and testing of the Starliner spacecraft, while NASA provides oversight and guidance throughout the process. The two organizations have a long history of collaboration, dating back to the Apollo program, and have worked together on a range of projects, including the Space Shuttle program and the ISS program. As of now, NASA and Boeing are eager to see the spacecraft perform in a real-world environment and are confident that it will meet the agency's high standards for safety and reliability. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.